السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. I'm your host Abdulaziz Hassan and welcome to a new episode of Ramadan in the Holy Quran. Now we are still contemplating on this very beautiful verse where God Almighty says, يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِكُمُ الْيُسْرَ وَلَا يُرِيدُ بِكُمُ الْعُسْرَ. Allah wanted to make it easy on you. Allah doesn't want to make it challenging or difficult for you. وَلِتُكُمُ الْعِدَّةِ, and so as to complete the number of the days that you have missed when you are traveling or sick. وَلِتُكَبِّرُ اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ, and we're still contemplating in this takbir and dhikr of Allah Azza wa Jal. We have mentioned previously that whenever we finish any ibadah like salat and hajj and also fasting, then the matter of dhikr comes. And there is a very big connection between dhikr and fasting. This is a day that shows that we love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are fasting and remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is only a little drop that coming down the throat when you are fasting and you are washing your mouth, you are trying, because you remember God, you're trying to take this drop out. This comes from the dhikr, when there is this very strong love between you and Allah Azza wa Jal. And for Allah is the best example. If we love someone, then our hearts will be trembling with his remembrance. For God is the best example. If we really remember Allah Azza wa Jal, if we really love him, then we'll be always remembering him, always meaning a lot. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the ayat related to the dhikr that dhikr should be a lot whenever you remember God. And the opposite is not to mention or remember God at all. No. He talked about the hypocrites. Do you know what Allah Almighty said about the hypocrites? لا يذكرون الله إلا قليلا. The hypocrites, they never mention Allah but little. So we don't want to fall into this category. You know, we want to remember Allah a lot as he has been advising us in the Quran. فَإِذَا قُضِيَتِ الصَّلَاةِ, and when the prayers finished, فَانْتَشِرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ, spread in the earth, وَابْتَغُوا مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ, and ask from the virtues of Allah, وَذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. Remember Allah a lot, and this a lot will be coming back and forth in the Quran whenever the remembrance of Allah comes. So as to show how important is the dhikr of Allah Azza wa Jal. The thing is in your tongue, is it the thing is in your heart, is the thing in your brain, you are possessed by the love of Allah Azza wa Jal. And what company do you want more than the greatness of God Almighty? And this is the thing that we find in each and every ayah. Allah Azza wa Jal says another ayah, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اُذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ, O you those who believe, remember Allah. What type of remembrance? ذِكْرًا كَثِيرًا, a lot. وَسَبِّحُوهُ, glorify him. بُكْرَةً, in the early morning. وَأَصِيلًا, and later in the day. فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ قَبْلَ طُلُوعِ الشَّمْسِ وَقَبْلَ الْغُرُوبِ. Glorify Allah Almighty before the sunrise and before sunset. وَمِنَ اللَّيْلِ فَسَبِّحُ, and also at night when you finish the night prayers. وَأَدْبَارَ السُّجُودَ, and right you finish your prostration. And this is the thing that is the most common practice while we are praying. We say, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allah greater than anything else. Whatever I do is nothing compared to the do's of Allah Azza wa Jal. So this is a very beautiful meaning that we carry, and it is always there. And you could listen to the Sahaba radwanullahu alayhim after each and every salat raising their Ibn Abbas said about this matter, ما كنا ندري عن انقضاء رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إلا بالتكبير. We didn't know that the Salat of Rasulullah, sometimes they came commuting just for pray and they might miss it. And this is sometimes they said, we don't know that they finish their Salat except by the takbir, by listening to all the Sahaba and companions saying, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, right after the Salat. So this shows the greatness of this type of ibadah. And by the way, this type of ibadah is very easy. It doesn't need power, it doesn't need light. You can drive and say, Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, La ilaha illallah, Akbar. You can be sitting, relaxing, laying back and saying, Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, Wallahu Akbar. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala even is advising us, الَّذِينَ ذَكُرُوا اللَّهَ قِيَامًا وَقُعُودًا وَعَلَى جُنُوبِهِمْ. Those who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while they're standing and while they're sitting and when they are leaning on the sides. Why? Because it's a very simple and easy way of ibadah. Whenever you don't have time for any type of ibadah, you still have the time to do the dhikr of Allah Azza wa Jal, to praise Allah Azza wa Jal and give him the thanks for he has provided us with this great ni'mah of him, which is Islam. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.